الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون
إن الحمد لله نستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Dear brothers and dear sisters, when it comes to our understanding of Islam, when it comes to understand what is the main objective of acknowledging التوحيد لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, that our relationship towards Allah is first to recognize that there is a creator. But this is only the starting point of the journey. The Prophet ﷺ came to show we the path, not only to acknowledge that there is one God. This is the starting point. But what is important in what in fact is a Sharia, and the Sharia is the way towards the source, meaning your life is going to be going and time is going to fly and pass. But what you should understand that you acknowledge that there is Allah and you are here in this mosque now saying La ilaha illallah and you acknowledge. This acknowledgement, this testimony is the starting point of a journey where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking you, I am close to you, come close to me. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِ عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ means I am close. But what is said just after this, أُجِيبُ الدَّعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ mean come. Talk to me. Come close. But this come close is not just only something that you say, I'm coming close to Allah. It's something which is a conversion of your heart. Come close ears, now we will see with your heart, not only with your mind. To say La ilaha illallah with your tongue and your mind is not enough. Come close with your heart. And the very essence of this is what is said in the Quran, where the deep understanding, why today we are trying to follow in the footsteps of the Prophet ﷺ, because we heard coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala something which is essential. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهُ, meaning you follow the messenger, the Prophet ﷺ, with one thing that you are seeking. It's not only to acknowledge, that's done. You say Bismillah, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, that's fine. Now there is something which is a fact and there is something which is a quality. The fact is there is one God. The quality is how. How do you worship Allah? And what is said in the Quran is in kuntum tuhibbun Allah, it's al-hub. What you are seeking is to love Him. And this should be visible not in the way you speak, but in the way you are. And to do this, the best example is follow the Prophet, follow the messenger, follow in the footsteps. Not in what? In the formal way, but in the deep way to understand his own personal spiritual journey. Not the limitations, not halal and haram. This is important, yes. But he himself went through stages. And you have to understand this. Let us come to the beginning. You know, to these surah, the chapters of the Quran that we read very quickly because they are very short. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked at the beginning the way the Prophet ﷺ was talking to human beings. At the end, few words, deep meaning. He was jawami al-kalim, The Prophet ﷺ was saying few words, but you have to think about it. You have to think about what he said. Come to the beginning of the Quran. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling the Prophet ﷺ, he's coming close to him. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ was trying to come close to him. He was isolating himself from the people. He was isolating himself from all these wrong beliefs to try to understand the very meaning. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is starting in with this first the first verses that you know. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اقرأ اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق اقرأ. And then we all stick to this and say, you know what? This is essential. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling us to knowledge. Iqra' means knowledge. That's true, but not only. It's deeper than this. The Prophet ﷺ is saying, as to the way I can read, I can't. Two times, three times. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is coming the third time through Jibreel alayhi salam. Iqra' bismi rabbik. Meaning, now it's time to read. But what it means to read? Take a book and try to read the book with your eyes. Impossible. Iqra means to associate your eyes and your minds. You need to understand. You need now to get it. There is a meaning in now what is coming to you. It's deep, the meaning. So much so that the Prophet ﷺ, talking to the companions once, he said, "Inna hadha al-Qur'ana nazala bihuzn." This Quran was revealed with sadness. Why? Because you cannot just live this life fil ghafla, forgetting the meaning. And it is said in the Quran, "La takunu kalladhina nasu Allah." Don't be like the people who are forgetting to recognize, but now to live by what they believe in, which is the presence of God everywhere. And what we try to get is this love, which is the essential meaning. It came from the very beginning, is try to get the very essence of your relationship with Allah. Now, the first thing, and you know this is important, it came with the first verses and it changed the way the Prophet ﷺ was to look at the world and to understand his presence. With these few first verses that were revealed, when you have, for example, وَاللَّيْلِ بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَخْشَى وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّى وَمَا خَلَقَ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى. Very simple words, but think about this. And then after this, إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. Meaning, look at the world. Look at the world, because this world is talking about my presence. And if you miss the point, if you look at the world without understanding, reading, read. Read the book means now you start reading the world in a new way. It's what we call in English, what is in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, what he said, Ya muqallib al-qulub. Ya muqallib al-qulub, you turn my heart in one direction or in another. This is why when someone is coming back to Islam, we tend to say in English, I'm reverting to Islam, coming back to the first stage, which is right, but not completely. There is very much something which is converting, changing, a revolution in your heart. Converting is right. It's not only reverting. It's I come back to the source by turning everything in the way I look at the world. And what he said, look, وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَخْشَى, when the night is covering everything. By the night that is covering everything, but the day that is now coming with this the light of the day, and the power that creates human beings, men and women. And this is the starting point of Islam. You follow the Prophet ﷺ, start with this. Start with what was said at the beginning, which is converting the way you deal with the creation, nature. It changed everything. And then it changed everything. What duha? وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى. Duha, which is the brightness of the day. And then it's talking about this. And remember, a few years later, Bilal alayhi salam, coming to the Prophet ﷺ and finding him crying, not because he heard there is hellfire, that not they heard there is punishment, no. إنا في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم and look at this ويتفكرون في خلق الله يتفكرون يتفكرون means they meditate, they think about what has been created. And means this relationship to Allah is something which is starting with the way we look at this and we start understanding that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us the revelation and giving us the creation. And He's questioning the quality of our relationship. And when we are coming with this, which is التفكر, it's the meditation, it's pondering, we get the meaning of why the Prophet ﷺ was crying because the starting point of our relationship to Allah is something which is the starting point of a relationship which is based on love. And this is why it is said, the relationship that we have, why do you talk to Allah? Why are you, for example, praying Allah? Because in fact, the first attitude, the first understanding following the Prophet ﷺ, when he was crying, when he was praying, it was essentially to thank Him for all what He gave us. And He gave us first the capacity to understand and the capacity to thank Him. This is why it is said in Surah Luqman, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةَ أَنِشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ فَمَنْ يَشْكُرْ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُ لِنَفْسِهِ. We gave wisdom to Luqman, thank Allah. And the one who is thanking Allah, he's thanking Him for His own sake. This is good for him. Why am I starting with this? You might say, oh, this is very far. In fact, the way you are with Allah through His creation is the way you are going to be with your fellow brothers and sisters in humanity. That the way you have to look at the world is to look at all what was given and to be able to follow in the footsteps of the Prophet ﷺ. He was someone, he was crying when he was getting verses talking about nature and creation. He was someone who was converted, who converted his heart from the very beginning with the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was telling him, look at the world in a new way. And this is why we have, when we speak about the people who are denying God, لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ آذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ. They have hearts they don't understand. لَا يَفْقَهُونَ. You know what is the very meaning of fiqh? Deep understanding. And deep understanding is that they have hearts and they have eyes and ears. They don't hear, they don't see, they don't feel, they don't understand. There is something missing. Why? Because in their relationship with nature and human being, they are very far. Let us start with this, because this understanding, when you go out from here, when you are in a society here in the United States of America, in Phoenix, sometimes the main problem that we have as Muslims is we miss the first point. How do you convert and you look at the world by outside in your daily life, being able to understand that if you are true to al-ihsan, and ta'bud Allah ka'annaka tara, means that when you go out, you remember Him. When you look at nature, when you look at this, and you are able to say, to thank Allah. Ishkurillah. Ishkur. And ishkurillah is a state of mind. The beginning of love is not to look at what is missing. The beginning of love is to look at what is given. This is the starting point. And then you change the way you look at the people. You don't look at the people but what is missing when they don't have money, but what they have when they have hearts. The people who look at power, they look at what the people have. And the people have, not what the people are. The one who is with Allah is looking at what the people are, forgetting what is missing. He's thinking before complaining. He is strong before thinking about his weakness or her weakness. This is the starting point of this journey towards Allah. And then we have to think about it. Wallahu a'lam wa a'la wa ahkam. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And then I'm just starting the journey, and we are following in the footsteps of the Prophet ﷺ. And this is the way he was himself educated. He was not educated first to look and judge people. He was first educated, look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you and thank him. And then now you have a mission. And this mission is the final point. The ultimate mission of the Prophet is what he said himself. إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمِ الْأَخْلَاقِ I was sent but to beautify, to complete the good character. Not only what was coming by through Islam, but what was, and we found it in the Christian tradition, in the Jewish tradition, and Islam is coming to confirm this. It's based on a relationship to Allah, which is acknowledging Him, knowing, reading, accepting, thanking, all what was given, and then you have to change the people. Then the way you look at the world, the way you celebrate the world, the way you are with nature and even animals, the way you look at al-layl, the way you look at al-nahar, the way you understand this very meaning that during fajr, and it's important, our relationship with time is essential. The way you wake up to work, to pray in the morning, al-fajr, mean you pray before sunset and you pray just before the light and just when the light is coming. Because in these times, there is something which is, that has an impact on you. And then you understand, following in the footsteps of the Prophet, that all this is changing a mentality. It's changing the way you have to look at the people and you have to look at yourself. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what he was teaching the Prophet ﷺ, as it is what we have to understand, is as you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you understand that you have to thank him, look at yourself and know something, that you have the means of your own liberation. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. And then if you understand that, you come back to yourself, you know that Allah is very close to you, you look at yourself, and always, always, you start with the positive side of yourself. Now, some of you are coming to pray here, and between today and next Friday, they are going to do bad things. Now you can think, you come and you forget about your prayer, you go outside and you think about, oh, I'm not good because I'm doing bad things. Let me tell you something. If Allah was not loving you, He would not call you to come to pray. The fact that you are here, that there is still something in your heart which is love, which is important, that you know that it's important. Don't judge yourself in a tough way by only looking at what is bad, but look at the fact that there are still something which is calling you to what is good and say thank you and start to change. Don't use all what you are doing, because some of us here, they go outside and they are doing things which is only based on, oh, I was told it's haram and I'm doing haram, so I'm bad. No, the fact that you know and still know that you are doing haram is very close to al-halal. So get it like this. This is what the Prophet ﷺ was dealing with people. Not starting, فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرْ لَسْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِمُسَيْطِرْ Dhakir means I'm calling you. Yes, you know it's wrong. You don't need, rules. Just listen to your heart. Estafti qalbak, and you will see there is something wrong. And if you still pray once and miss four prayers, come back to the one and stick to this and start the journey, the jihad, to change your life. If you look at the power of what is good, you can change what is bad. But if you are completely disappointed with what is bad in you, you are going to be lost for the rest of your life. So this is where you understand, you start by thinking. Thinking means I look what is positive. And as much as you do this with yourself, al-muraqaba means check, come back to yourself. Istafti qalbak means check what is your heart. And if there is one spark of what is good, come back to this and say, thank you. thank you, and come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is where you understand that if there is this spark, is still that there is this connection, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is close to your heart. And then you understand what was said to, what was Luqman was saying to his son. When he was calling him, when he was telling him, Ya bunayya, it means also anishkur li waliwalidayka. And this is something which is very important. You know what is your contribution? Anishkur li waliwalidayka. Al-hubb here, it's based on two things. Two things. The first, we have two words in Arabic, which is one which is coming from this relationship with the mother, which is al-rahma. That we understand Silat al-Rahim, al-Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is connecting to us in such a way, which is deep love. And his deep love is to our being, even if we are not good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is Rahim wa Rahman with all human beings, even you when you do bad, and even the kuffar when they are doing bad. He is showing rahmah. But he doesn't show love, hub, with the people who are doing bad. Between al-rahmah wa hub is your jihad towards him. He takes you from the beginning as human being wa rahman. But as to Allah yuhibbu al-muqsitin, in Allah yuhibbu al-sabirin, those who are striving, from his rahmah as to your being to his love as to your striving to be close to him. And what we want is this. So in our understanding is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us all this, and we have to struggle. Ask yourself in your daily life from where you are, and you should understand here that the first visible dimension of your faith, and I say this here in the United States of America, be careful not to be colonized, not by you know, being consumerist, not by living the life of the people. You know what is the first very dangerous colonization? Is your relationship with your parents. Is to lose this. Is to forget the relationship with your father and your mother and all the people who are close to you. You may have them here living, and they may have passed away, and you don't even know where they are. And even now, you may have bad relationship. But there is something. Anishkur li wali walidayka. And this is not easy. It's a jihad to love your parents. Because there is the natural love towards your parent. But there is something which is deeper in the way you have to love them more and to serve them. To serve them. And it doesn't mean that this love is blind in everything. وَإِنْ جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا. You love them with principles, with understanding. This is why لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا. You love with your heart and understanding. I'm not going to love you. I am not going to love you with your injustice. I love you despite your injustice, but I'm going to struggle against your injustice to show you my true love. This is Islam. This is the way we have to be at home. And then you go out. And then you understand that this is where you Muslims, in this society with your brothers, in this community, you have to be less judgmental and much more loving. And, you know, many of the people who are Muslims are not here today. Many are not in the mosque today. Many, they know exactly that they are doing wrong. Do you think that what they need is for you to go and to say you are doing wrong? They know this. They want much more heart and much less judgment. What they want is for you to welcome them. Fadhakkir, say the good things. Talk about the good dimension, the way we have to deal with, you know, the people who are lost by showing solidarity, showing love to people, showing love to people who are outside. Islam is all about this. Of course, al-halal, halal, wal-haram, haram. That's not discussion. You're not going to do things haram just to show that you love. No, there are limits. But please, in your situation, in this society, show this rahmah. Ruhama baynahum. Ashidda' ala al-kuffar. And al-kuffar are the people who are knowing the truth and denying the truth. Not the great majority of the Americans. You can't say to them, you are kuffar. Be careful with the concept of kuffar. Kafir means you know the truth and you deny the truth. Many of your fellow Americans, they don't even know. Instead of judging them, they're saying you're all kuffar. Just know that there are people who need to get a better understanding of Islam. And the better understanding of Islam is you. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ. You have to bear witness to your message in front of people, before people, in this society. So this is a quest. This is a call. This is a journey. And it means it starts with your own self. It starts with your home. It starts with your kids. It starts with this society where, in this society, you follow in the footsteps of the Prophet ﷺ. And the Prophet ﷺ was not starting by judging the people. He was starting by serving them. He came with a mission and he was listening. He came with a vision and he was educating the people out of love, out of respect, knowing that the people have resources and potentials that you cannot just imagine. You have to come with this. And then he said something which was once again about love. You might say you give zakat because it's a duty. The Prophet ﷺ was not asking this. He was saying, Allahumma nas'aluka hubba al-masakeen. I'm not asking you just to give me the power to give to the poor. I'm asking you to love them. Meaning to change my heart and to be able to love them. And this is why, as Muslims, we need to work on this, to follow the Prophet ﷺ, not only in the way he was behaving apparently with the rules, but the way he was educating deeply with his heart, with his presence, in the way he was showing solidarity and love to the poor people. And he changed the world, not with the power of the powerful, but with the people who were apparently powerless. But they were convinced and they were loving him. They were ready for the Prophet ﷺ. They were loving him and they were loving the message. And they were ready to die for this. And for you today in this society, it's still very important, if you follow the Prophet ﷺ, not to transform our messenger, not to transform ﷺ, not to transform our message, not to transform our relationship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala into something which is only based on rules and not based on this very understanding. The way he was converted by looking at nature in another way. The way he was converted by the way he was looking at the poor in his society. The way he was spreading this understanding. And it was so much the case that the people around him didn't want to leave him. They wanted to be close to him. They knew how much he was spreading around this understanding. So as Muslims, this is what we need to understand deeply. And in our communities here in the West, just take this and follow the Prophet ﷺ in this. You are not here to judge the people. You are not here to reject the people. You are here to do what he did. لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمِ الْأَخْلَاقِ is the way you behave. Come in the United States of America by serving yourself. Serving yourself, take time for your mind, take time for your heart, take time for yourself. Second, to serve your family, take time for your wife, take time for your husband, take time for your kids. To serve the community, take time to serve the poor, take time to educate the people. Don't come with halal haram, just give, 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 and assess who you are, but what you give. Contribute, do something. Love the and the way you are dealing with the poor, the way you are dealing with this society. Make this society a better society. Act against your own weaknesses in the way we are ourselves, Muslims. Too much racist. Us Muslims towards judgmental. Us Muslims, we are too much nationalistic, too much based and promoting our very narrow understanding of my trend, my school, my organization. This was not the way the Prophet ﷺ was. His mind was open and his heart was serving, inshallah. And let us think about this. And when you pray, when you make dua, this supplication, once again, remember, you are thanking him. You are talking to him. And this is the time you open your heart, not to close it after the dua, but to have light that نسعى به بين الناس. That we go with this light with and among the people, inshallah. اللهم نسألك بأننا نشهد أنك أنت الله الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. اللهم نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم نعوذ بك من أن نشرك بك شيئا نعلمه ونستغفرك لما لا نعلمه. اللهم اجعلنا من الموحدين. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل التوحيد. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يقولون لا إله إلا أنت لا حول ولا قوة إلا بك. اللهم تقبل صلاتنا وركوعنا وسجودنا. اللهم تقبل أعمالنا. اللهم قوي إيماننا واشرح لنا صدورنا وثبتنا يا رحمن يا رحيم واجعلنا من الصابرين الصديقين المقربين المحبوبين. اللهم اجعلنا من المحبوبين. فاللهم نسألك حبك وحب من يحبك والعمل الذي يبلغنا حبك يا رحمن يا رحيم. أنت رب العالمين. أنت ربنا فاغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا وسامحنا. اللهم ارحمنا. اللهم تب علينا. اللهم ارحم والدينا. اللهم ارحم والدينا ووالدي والدينا. اللهم اغفر لجميع موتى المسلمين الذين شهدوا لك بالوحدانية ولنبيك بالرسالة وماتوا على ذلك. اللهم أكرم نزلهم ووسع مدخلهم. اللهم أنزل على قبورهم الضياء والنور والفسحة والسرور. اللهم قوي إيمان إخواننا وأخواتنا المظلومين في كل مكان. اللهم استجب دعاءهم. اللهم انصرهم على أعدائهم. اللهم عليك بالظالمين. اللهم عليك بالظالمين. اللهم قوي إيمان إخواننا وأخواتنا واجعلنا جميعا من الصابرين. وألف بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات بيننا واجعلنا يا رحمن يا رحيم من المقربين من المحبوبين ومن الصابرين. وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. وأقم الصلاة.